Hello everyone, Brian LeMaster here with Innovative Tactical Concepts. Right now what I want to do is talk about the three rings or three layers of protection in your church security plan. Now, if you've been to an executive protection school or you know anything about executive protection, three rings is pretty commonly known, the three layers of protection. You have your outer ring, your inner ring, and then your core ring, okay? So, ideally you want to stop the potential threat at the outer ring, okay? So this would be your parking lot area or outside or whatever you want to, you know, whatever your area or your environment consists of, okay? Typically 65% of things happen outside, so you want to try to deter or defuse any situations outside. So you really need to have a strong presence outside. You need to have staff out there, security staff with security shirts on, possibly, you know, even with guns exposed or not. I'm not a big person on having guns exposed, but having a good trained team in place that knows how to use their guns or is trained in unarmed combative, so on and so forth, is always to your advantage. But a strong presence outside is probably going to deter most things from ever happening, simply because most people are not looking for a confrontation, they're looking for an easy fight, okay? Now, you're looking for things out of the ordinary. Not everybody has the ability to pick up on things that don't look right, okay, DLRs. You know, I have that knack, a lot of people have that knack, but not everyone has that knack. I can look at somebody and say, hey, you know, there's something wrong with them, they're up to no good or whatever. It's just one of those abilities that I have, but not everybody has it. But, you know, if you know anything about body language, you can pick up on people who are about to do something wrong. Now, I know this may sound crazy because we're talking about church, okay? And a lot of people don't believe in having security at church, but it is a necessity, and it's actually biblical, and we can give you verses on that, scripture on that, and it's on our website, and we have a lot more than that. But the thing is that I treat and I teach people to treat everyone as a potential threat. Just because I've known you 20 years doesn't mean I go, well, that's Bob, come on in, Bob, and I don't pay attention to Bob, because everybody is a potential threat. You don't know what's going on in their life, okay? You don't know what secrets that they have and what they're struggling with, so I treat everybody the same, okay? So again, the parking lot, the outside needs to have a heavy presence. The next layer is the foyer or entry points, okay? So let's say you have 12 entrances to your church, okay? Say it's a decent sized church and you have 12 entrances. You need to lock down most of those entrances. You don't want people just coming in all sides of the building. You want to control where they come in, especially if you don't have a very big team or you don't have a video surveillance system in place that can cover all that. Typically speaking, you want the fewest number of entrances possible that you can man and monitor, so that way you can scan people when they're coming in and things like that, check bags if you have to, so on and so forth. So basically the second layer is trying to catch what the first layer may have missed. All right, we hope that it doesn't happen, but let's face it, this is reality. So the third layer is the sanctuary, the kids ministry area, the Sunday school area, anywhere that people are going to be in large numbers, because if an active shooter situation takes place, this is what they're after, okay? They're after a body count. So realistically, these rings should overlap, okay? It doesn't mean that, you know, the parking lot is somebody else's job and the foyer is somebody else's job and the kids area is somebody else's job. These rings should overlap in some manner. Now, ideally you would have at least one or two team members roaming, okay? Maybe the team leaders are great for this, the assistant team leaders are great for this. They're roaming and they're going to cover and intersect those rings, okay? So they're going to provide the crossover of the protection, okay? You can also do it through video surveillance, all right? So you can have team members' actual physical bodies and surveillance systems that overlap. And of course, you need someone monitoring that video surveillance system, all right? So if you do your job correctly, okay, especially the outside people, if you have a good, strong presence, a confidence, you know, a professionally trained team that is confident, then the odds of something bad happening at your facility are probably pretty slim, in my opinion, because, again, most people aren't looking for a fight. You're more likely to deter something by having, you know, the protective detail outside than you are by not having them outside, because you don't want that fight getting to the building. Okay, you want to de-escalate that or deter that altogether. Now, here's something that a lot of people don't think about, is that when does the fight begin? You really don't know. Okay, so you can't say, well, nothing's happened here. You know, we've been in, you know, a team for a year or 3 years or whatever. You don't know when that fight begins. It could begin 10 months ago. Somebody's planning, you know, maybe not necessarily against your church, but they're planning something bad, and they just happen to be driving by your church, or maybe they have it out for your church. Maybe they've been hurt in some way. So you don't know when that fight begins, so you always have to be on your toes. When does the fight end? You don't know. Simply put, you don't know. Is it when they go to the hospital or to the morgue or to jail? You don't know. Okay. So again, you don't know when the fight begins and you don't know when it ends. There's no way to know that. Now, having enough people to do what needs to be done is always going to be a challenge. You know, my father said a long time ago, 2% of the people are willing to do the work and the other 98% are willing to let you do it. I've found that to be true in most churches. But you may not have enough people to do the plan, the ideal plan, okay? But you need to work something out. You need to have a presence outside no matter what, again, because we feel that it's going to deter most things. And if you can't afford video surveillance systems, we understand that too. But, you know, try to do what you can in order to get that in place. So again, having the three rings or three layers of protection is the ideal plan. You may or may not be able to you know, implement that plan. Now, if you have four security people, then odds are you can do that if you do it correctly, okay? But again, you know, this is ideal. It's not going to work for everybody necessarily because of the lack of manpower and or other resources, okay? So if you have any training needs or you have any questions about this topic, feel free to comment on this video or contact me through my website, okay, which is on your screen, and it's going to be on the trailer. So just remember, people, this is a very, very serious ministry, and you know, you can't take it lightly, okay? So if you are involved in the church security or safety team ministry, this is not a glorified position. This is a position that is really a humble servant position. So, and you need to take it seriously. I know you're not getting paid, but you are serving the Lord. So serve the Lord with all your heart and all your might, and you know, always try to do what's right in God's eyes. May God bless your ministry beyond belief.